throughout most of high school, I was a B student. I worked just hard enough to keep my parents happy, but I never really excelled at anything. Then, the first university I went to, I was a B student there as well, sometimes a B minus student. Again, I didn't really excel at any subject. Then I transferred to another university, and there I had a professor that treated me like an A student. I'm not too sure why he did, but he just treated me like I was, and guess what happened? I started getting A's, not just in his class, but in all of them. Because he looked at me and saw an A student, I started to act that way. And this isn't a rare occurrence. In fact, the reverse is well documented, that if a student is assumed to be unintelligent and not likely to succeed, the student might start acting that way, even if the student didn't start out like that. I'm very thankful I had a professor that looked at me like I was an A student. It changed my whole life. We're reading Peter's first letter together, and in that letter, Peter says something quite amazing. He says this, "As obedient children, do not conform to the evil desires you had when you lived in ignorance, but just as he who called you is holy, so be holy in all you do." Peter has a lot packed into this, but here's one thing he's communicating. God made you a holy child of God. That's who you are. God looks at you and he sees a spiritual straight A child of God. He sees you that way because when Jesus died, he clothed you in his righteous life, and now God looks at you and sees Jesus' righteous life. God looks at you and sees a spiritual straight A child of God. And so what should we do? Peter says, act like who you are. Be who you are. Since you have been made holy in God's sight, start acting like it. And that begins with not conforming with the evil you see around you. That means not giving in to the temptation to boil over in wrath if you think your boss or your neighbor or your government isn't handling this pandemic the way they should. Maybe the world expects everyone to act like that, but don't conform. That means looking at your possessions and money and advantages that you have that others don't, and being generous to those who need help. Maybe the world expects you to hunker down and hold on to what's yours. But, Peter says, don't conform. Of course, we're not going to be able to be holy. God calls us to be a life we can't keep. But when we fail, Jesus is right there with his forgiveness, saying, it'll be okay. Your sins are forgiven. God still loves you, and he's still right here with his word, calling you to get out there and work on it. And so we do. We confess, we bask in forgiveness, and then we get right back to the work of acting like a holy, precious child of God with a whole lot of love to give, because that's who you are. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for making me holy in your sight through Jesus. Please keep me close to your word, where I learn that holiness comes from being clothed in Jesus. And then call me to action, to be who I am, a saved sinner who has the love of Jesus to share. Amen.
The King of love, my shepherd is, whose goodness fails.